chasing, so I'm chasing wealth. Haters can't see me, I'm flying still.
Dance from your core. Flat, click, click, my fist. Bounce, come up now. Hit the ground and go. Yeah, I am walking slow. Turn around, throw the tennis. Get that ball out, throw it real fast. That's it.
Here with the Footwork Kings here in Chicago. How you guys doing today?
Hey, how you doing?
Doing great.
Tired.
Yeah, I'm tired.
Why are you tired?
Because we go high.
Because you go high, because they go high. So I want to have you guys introduce yourselves.
The lady first.
My name is Dionetta Jackson, also known as Little Bit.
Drum Boy, also known as Prince J-Ron.
Paul Zeddy, also known as Paul's Gonna Kill.
Paul's gonna kill.
Yeah.
You gonna kill? You gonna kill with the footworks right though.
Anything I do.
Oh, you got a little cockiness. I like this. You go ahead and give you a hug. Got the ripped jeans and everything. He gonna kill something today.
You can't give 50% of nothing you do.
I know that's what I said again.
So Paul's gonna kill.
Everything. Paul's gonna kill and you can't give 50% of nothing in what
100.
You 100. I love that. So tell me a little bit about the Footwork Kings is obviously you guys love the art of footworking. So why did you particularly choose that style of dance?
Well, born and raised in Chicago, it's a dance style that was started and created in Chicago, which evolved from house music back in the 80s. Over time, the music changed, sped up, and went to a style of music called juke. And so the movement sped up with it. So as of right now, it's, you know, Chicago footwork is a mixture of tribal dance, you got jazz, swing, tap. It's a mixture of it, but this style of dance is something that we do that saved a lot of lives in Chicago from doing something negative. So we just represent something in a positive way and take our energy and talents to the stage.
Awesome. And the one thing that I love about this group is that in all of the groups that we are interviewing today is that you guys are young, you know, and with the given things about, you know, Chicago and all of the gun violence, we need young people to be doing something positive. So I certainly commend you guys on that. So you performed. Did you perform already? Or?
Oh, yeah. We already lit the stage with our feet and it was an amazing, amazing show, amazing crowd. We just gave them our energy. They gave us ours. And so it was just a wonderful thing. I know a lot of cameras out there probably taped the show too, but if you missed it, then you might have to check it out on YouTube or something.
Now, have any one of you guys worked with any celebrities or anything, or no, not yet?
Well, our crew have been on America.
He talking too much.
Well, I know my crew type, like, you know, like Lil Bitch, she done did two pieces tonight, you know. Our piece that we actually did tonight was actually choreographed by, you know, Pauls. So we, you know, just did a highlight for his piece tonight. But as far as the crew, Chicago Forward Kings, we've been on America's Got Talent, ABDC, America's Best Dance Crew, Madonna, Sticky and Sweet World Tour 1 and 2. We did stuff with Nicki Minaj, Willow Smith, Twista, so many celebrities we done did work with and talk. And we just been spreading the dance style. So Les Twins, we just did, you know, some work with Les Twins, which is Beyonce and Jay-Z main dancers. So we just been networking and just spreading the Chicago culture worldwide, teaching. And at the same time, we just been trying to inspire others.
Now, let me get these other two because you've been speaking a lot, but you're doing an excellent job. So for for those who those dancers who may not know about footworking or want to get into footworking, what advice would you give them?
Well, the first thing I would say was don't just look at it and think it's so difficult. A lot of people, when they see the style, they just think off back, oh, I'm not going to be able to do this. I'm going to be tired.
Well, you are a little tired.
See, I'm tired because we're doing Chicago footwork at the highest skill,
okay,
which is 180 to 190 beats per minute. So imagine doing that 5 to 10 minutes, know what I'm saying, nonstop, no break.
100 and
on a Marley floor.
Marley? Like Bob Marley? Like
No.
Okay.
Floor,
I know. Don't talk about they flow. Now, girl, don't talk about they flow.
Certain floors
work better for us than other floors.
Okay.
Okay, so that's a tip. So as you were saying.
Yeah, so to anyone who don't know, you know, like what Chicago footwork is, all of us know how to teach it. It's not difficult at all. We break it down. The most thing I think people love as far as learning Chicago footwork is understanding that they're building their stamina and they're also working out their body. So it's not just about the style of dance. It's also about fitness. So little do they know that their body is bouncing every second they move. So that's working their abs, their legs, their arms. And they don't notice it afterwards when they start feeling the pain, just like if they went to the fitness center or whatever. Like it pops in probably at night when they sleep and they wake up crawling.
Nightmare. So, he said, you're going to crawl if you footwork. Now, where can we find you guys on social media?
On Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, it's just at Footwork Kings. And then you can go to footworkkings.com. And then we all have individual social media pages if you want that.
Yes. What's your social media?
Mine is dance_a_littlebit on Twitter and Instagram. And on Facebook, it's Dionetta Little Bit Jackson.
Okay. Little bit, little bit.
Little bit. Mine's would be Prince, J-R-O-N. And that's for everything. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. Follow me. Follow back.
You know. And you?
Paul's going to kill.
Paul's going to kill. I'm going to send you a message. Now, can we get a little bit of a little taste of what you guys do? The Footwork Kings. Go ahead and knock yourself out a little bit. You look like, yeah, a little bit, because he tired and he been talking all day. So you get a chance. What, y'all lazy? Y'all, like, don't let me get the footworking up in here. Don't let me get the footworking.
The best thing about her is that she also mixed tap.
You be, girl, you better get your little bit. Come on, girl. Come on, girl.
You know how to mix it.
I love.
You know how to mix tap and footwork?
I try most of the time.
You know, back in my day.
I just do that and I do that, and if it just happens to happen at the same time, then that's what happens.
5 to 10 seconds, little bit.
So you said tap was the original street dance. You
in
don't
America,
in America. Come on, girl. Give us just a little bit taste. Just 5 to 10. Showcase you. You know I'm little Oprah. You little bit. I'm little Oprah.
Okay.
Now that takes too much.
She's doing a warm up here.
Here we go.
She's getting ready to blaze the stage. Go ahead. Let me move over this way. She did a little gigolo, whatever you call that. you gonna hear something? Go ahead and knock yourself out. He throwing Michael Jackson in. All right. Paul gon' kill. You can't do it. You can't do it. Yeah, you got Paul gon' kill. You gotta knock him out the box. Yes. Wow, that was awesome, guys. The Footwork Kings. I love it. I love it. So keep doing what you're doing in the city of Chicago, influencing young people to go out there and live their dreams.
Yes, indeed. And can I add something? If anybody want to learn, you should take Paul's class at the lab.
At the lab? What's the information on that?
Well, Monday I teach Intro Chicago Footwork, which is beginner. That's 6 to 7 p.m. And Thursday I teach Advanced Chicago Footwork, but it's actually Intro 2. It's just more technical on R&B maybe or hip-hop.
Okay.
And that's 7 to 8 p.m.
You know what? I'm going to take your class. We're going to bring the cameras too.
The lab is at 925 West Chicago Avenue.
Awesome. So make sure you check out Paul's Gonna Kill You class. Footwork Kings in the building.
Ain't footworking water is you breathing.
I am here live again with another awesome group of dancers. I'm going to have them introduce themselves.
Oh, sorry.
I'm sorry. I'm a star. You can't hold my mic. Thank you.
My bad. My name is Star.
Star. And what group are you in?
Mad Rhythms and Purified Entertainment.
My name is Nico. I'm representing Sour Apples and Just Listen.
And we saw this young lady already. She's like in 55 groups. What are the other two groups that you're in?
I'm also in Mad Rhythms and Creation Battle Click.
She's just a busy little bee. So tell me the type of, we know that she does footworking. Now tell me the type of styles of dance that you all do.
Well, tonight I did tap, and then I was in another guy's set, Mikey Thomas. His set was called Project 7, and that was hip-hop dance.
Okay.
I've studied many forms of dance, but I'm mainly a tap dancer now.
And then outside of footwork, oh, look at this gentleman. Hi, how are you? Introduce yourself.
My name's Tristan Bruins. I'm a tap dancer.
And what group are you in?
I'm in the Star Dixon 5 Tet.
So, why are you guys laughing? What? The what?
Because he just made that up. Right
now. Are you serious? Are you like, what group are you in?
Mad Rhythms.
So he's gonna, but that's his. He's gonna form a group, and I'm gonna be in it. So that's.
Well, he actually has his own group also.
Okay, what group?
Tapman Productions.
So a lot of tap dancers here. Awesome. So what made you guys want to get into dance?
I'm not very good at anything else.
You're funny, ain't you?
Tap dance is pretty straightforward, and it's not too difficult, so.
For us non-dancers, that's not difficult at all.
Well, it's a good option if you can't stretch your leg over your head. I mean, I'm no Nico Rubio, so I'm not that flexible like that. Okay. I'm not a master of all styles. Okay.
You specialize in tap?
Sure. Yeah, I think we all do. So.
Not her. She specializes in everything.
Oh, yeah. Yes, she does.
So what about you do? You said you do tap and hip hop. So tell me, like, what's the difference between the two?
Well, one is more with the feet. Okay. Tap is about the movement and the musicality of the feet. And hip hop is about the whole body.
Just the whole body. So that's the difference. And what about you?
I got inspired by seeing the Jesse White Tumblers when I was in middle school, and then I studied all forms of dance, and then once I got introduced to Mad Rhythms and to freestyling, that's where I found my voice was specific to tap dancing.
Awesome. So where can we find you guys on social media?
Well, Mad Rhythms has a page on Instagram and Facebook, but you can find me at and Twitter. Okay. You can find me at Star Dixon on Instagram and Facebook. Okay.
On Twitter and Instagram at Shy Tappin, ChiTappin.
Facebook, Tapman Productions.
And you again.
I gave you my information.
Give it again.
Dance_A_little_bit. Well, LILBIT. Okay.
So I want to give a little.
That's Mad Rhythms. That's with two D's. MADDRHYTHMS.
Okay, awesome. So I want to give I want you to give our audience a little bit of a taste of dancing. So each one of you have to dance, and you have to give us a little, like another style of dance. Ha ha. You first, funny man. Can I see what you got?
Do your hip hop.
I mean, do whatever style of dance you want to do.
He has his own style of hip hop.
Love it.
Yes, Tristan.
I love it. Love it. Who's next? Who's next, young lady? Or young gentleman? Young lady? Yes, you, hon.
Young lady with the pink pants.
Pink pants, the hot pink pants. Hey. Good. Next person. You with the tap dance. I know you did the footworking before, but I want to see some tap. Now, I promise you I won't have you go again because you're in like 55 groups. So we do. So there you have it. Again, these awesome dancers that are in all types of genres, tap, footworking, hip hop. So you got to check them out via their social media pages. This is Mocha again chiming in at the Carnival Choreographers Ball. This is this exciting magazine pamphlet that I'm here. I'm here again with another dance group. They're actually not a group. They're separate. They've been dancing for a number of years, danced for various different celebrities. So I'm going to have them introduce themselves.
Hi, my name is D with two E's.
D with two E's.
Hi, my name is Corey. No E.
Corey, no E.
And I'm just TK.
TK, no E's, no A's, no A-E-I-O-U's. So, guys, tell me how long have you been dancing?
Well, I've been dancing since I was about 16. I started my sophomore year in high school. I joined my high school group. And from there, I met people who I networked with and just got the ball rolling from there.
Okay, sounds good.
I've been dancing for probably about the last 8 years, and started probably like when I was in like high school, senior year, and just been dancing. I've been doing other stuff, dancing, acting, singing, all that stuff.
Full-fledged entertainer, huh?
Well, me, I've been dancing since I was really little. At birthday parties, you know, nothing really too big, but as far as like stage-wise, since about 2007.
And what is your favorite type of dance?
I prefer hip-hop, you know, technical, modern, kind of modern, but mostly hip hop.
Okay, hip hop, modern.
My favorite is hip hop as well, but I'm very interested in like contemporary style too. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
I don't know what that is.
me personally to perform. I perform hip hop. I'd rather do that, but I'm just intrigued by all styles of dance. Dance is just it's in the form of expression. It speaks different languages, so I love all styles. You know. Yeah.
Now, what celebrities have you worked with in the art of dance?
Well, I've the closest I've got was legendary R&B singer CC Peniston.
He said the closest I've gotten, like, you know.
That's just the closest I've gotten.
That's
so
the
far.
Closest.
So, yeah, you know, I'm on my way, though.
You was with a legend. That was awesome. That was awesome. She's been in the game for a number of years, so that's great. What about yourself?
Well, I haven't really background danced or danced anything. I've pretty much done everything from like acting to singing and dancing and stuff. So I've done opening acts for celebrities like Tierra Marie, Chris Brown, Bow Wow, Don from Danity Kane.
Yeah. And the list goes on and on with his humble self. You know, I haven't really, but you know, I'm open for, you know, blah, 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 blah. Right. And what about yourself?
I've worked with D Woods from Danity Kane. Also Jazzy Faye.
Jazzy Faye. Yes. You know, I'm a little old school. I remember Jazzy Faye. So where can people contact you via social media?
My Facebook name is D John, DeeJohn. My Instagram is dexpose, DEE underscore three X's, OSEED. Sorry.
That's
DEE underscore triple X POSED.
Okay. Right. We're going to make sure the camera guy spells that all out. That's a long triple X and three X's, yeah. And DMX and stuff. Yeah.
DMX. My Facebook is just Corey Hartzell. That's CORYHARTZOL. My Instagram is choreography. That's CORYOGRAPHYY. And yeah, that's it.
Facebook is just TK Richardson. Instagram, TK Music, TKMUSIQ.
Sounds good. Now I'm going to have you guys do a little bit of dancing. Yeah, we got to get you guys on camera to do a little bit of dancing, whatever type of dance that you want to do. So we're going to clear the floor here. Yes, acapella. That's a nice outfit you got. What you got on?
Oh,
hold on. Let me see. Wait a minute. We got to get this outfit. Look at this.
Oh, thank you. Yeah, this is a little something I just picked up today.
He just picked it up today. He's fashionable as well. Go ahead and knock yourself out, guys. It's whatever. Goodness, I love it. Y'all twisting and a turning and twisting and a turning again. So you guys got to check them out via their social media pages. Make sure that you support them. These are young men that are doing something positive in the city of Chicago. They're not out here game banging. They're out here dancing and doing something positive and doing the art and the things that they love. Thank you.
Yeah!